What's up?
Pancreatic enzymes can be divided into two major subgroups. Enzymes that we use to determine acute pancreatic injury, its amylase and lipase, and enzyme that we use to determine pancreatic insufficiency that develops in chronic pancreatitis, its fecal pancreatic elastase. Amylase and lipase are pancreatic enzymes. They both are located inside the acina cells in pancreatic tissue, and inside the acina cells they are stored in form of vesicles. So, if starch or lipids come to the duodenum, acina cells transport vesicle to the cellular membrane and then release amylase and lipase into the pancreatic duct. Then amylase and lipase are delivered to the duodenum, where they will provide digestion of starch and lipids. But as any cell in human organism, acina cells of the pancreatic tissue require tissue renewal. We constantly have to replace old cells with new cells. So in this process of cellular turnover, constantly some amount of acina cells die. With death, their membrane integrity becomes disrupted, and cellular content, including lipase and amylase, released into the blood. In normal condition, renewal of the acina cells produce 25 to 125 units per liter of amylase and 10 to 160 units per liter of lipase.
Have I made myself clear, boys?
Yeah, that's perfectly clear, Mickey, yeah. Just give me 1 minute to confer with my colleague.
But in acute pancreatitis, if injury to the pancreatic cell occurs, injury causes death of acina cells. So now it's not only death of pancreatic cells because of cellular turnover, it's also death of pancreatic cells because of pancreatic injury. The higher the amount of pancreatic cells die, the more inner content of acina cells released into the blood, including amylase and lipase. As a result, the amount of amylase and lipase increase. So now the level of lipase and amylase will become greater than 500 units per liter, for example, which is much higher than normal. So pathological elevation of both amylase and lipase is a sign of massive injury of the pancreatic tissue. That's why we use them as a marker of acute pancreatitis. As we see, both lipase and amylase have some similar features, but we consider lipase a more specific enzyme. The reason is that 99% of lipase in our organism is secreted by acina cells of the pancreatic tissue. But amylase is secreted not only by the pancreatic tissue, but also by the salivary glands in the oral cavity. And salivary glands secrete a significant amount of lipase. So amylase can be also elevated, for example, in case of inflammation of the salivary glands, so-called cellulodenitis. But if lipase is elevated, then most probably it's a pathology of the pancreatic tissue. And elevation of both amylase and lipase more than 3 times of the upper limit of normal is a diagnostic criteria for acute pancreatitis.
What?
Another enzyme that we determine is fecal pancreatic elastase. The concept is that elastase is an enzyme that is produced and stored in acina cells of the pancreatic tissue. And when some proteins come to the duodenum, acina cells secrete elastase into the duodenum. In the duodenum, elastase provides digestion of small proteins, and after digestion of proteins, elastase is excreted in the feces. And if we assess the level of elastase in the stool, the level of elastase in normal condition is more than 200 micrograms per gram. But if acute pancreatitis is repeated multiple times, with chronic damage to pancreatic tissue, pancreatic cells progressively die, and dead acina cells are replaced by the connective tissue. This condition known as chronic pancreatitis.
There's something very wrong with this.
Connective tissue is non-functional tissue, it cannot secrete enzymes. So in chronic pancreatitis, because the amount of acina cells decrease, elastase secretion decrease, thereby proteins digestion decrease and the concentration of elastase in feces decrease. The amount of elastase less than 200 micrograms per gram is considered as a marker of a moderate to mild exocrine pancreatic insufficiency. And in severe chronic pancreatitis, the amount of alive acina cells becomes very low. With decrease in eosinophils, elastase secretion decrease. With decrease in elastase, protein's digestion decrease. This results in protein malabsorption and excretion of undigested proteins in the stool. And in this case, the amount of elastase in feces is very low. And the amount of elastase less than 100 micrograms per gram is a marker of severe exocrine pancreatic insufficiency.
Did you understand a single word of what you just said?
So, to determine how severe is pancreatic insufficiency, we can measure the amount of elastase in the stool. And the lower the elastase in the stool, the less amount of live cells are present in the pancreatic tissue. So, the more severe is the pancreatic insufficiency.
Great. Fine. Yep.
Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao.
It's Italian. It means food.